friends, today I am going to explore about state space search. So state space search is a simple tree structure in which each and every node corresponds to a specific state. So we can say that it is a set of states where successor function is applied to move from current to next state. So here nodes are not initially generated, but they are generated as they are explored. Now here are the strategies. Two strategies are present: uninformed or blind search, and second is informed or heuristic search. Now this blind search is sometimes also known as brute force. So it includes BFS, DFS, bidirectional, uniform cost, depth limited, iterative deepening, and heuristic approach. There are two types: pure heuristic and local algorithms. So pure includes A star, AO star, greedy BFS, and local search includes hill climbing, and this two are types of hill climbing. Now let's move on to strategy one, uninformed or blind. So here there is no need of domain specific knowledge, and this strategy applies on small number of states. Now here is the first approach, BFS, breadth first search. So this is implemented with the help of Q data structure. So the rule followed will be FIFO, first in will be always first out. Now how all the nodes are explored? So first of all, it will explore A, then it will move to next level, B, C, then it will move to next level. It will scan D, E, F, and G. Then again it will move to next level, H, I, J, K, and then finally L. So here both the time and space complexities are similar, big O, B raised to D plus 1, where D is the depth and B is branching factor. Branching factor means it is nothing but it shows the number of child nodes any parent node can have. Now second approach, DFS. So DFS is implemented with the help of stack data structure, and it will use last in first out rule. So in this tree, if we apply DFS, then what will be the series of nodes? First of A, then B, then D and H. So it will go to the maximum depth at the first time. So DFS has time complexity of big O B raised to D, and the space complexity of B raised to D plus 1. Now bidirectional search. So here both the start and goal node start searching in opposite direction. So this start node will search in this direction, goal node will search in this direction, and wherever these two search meet, they will consider it as optimal. Is uniform cost search. So uniform cost search expands each and every node that is with the lowest path cost, and it doesn't care about the number of steps that any path contains, but instead it will focus on only total cost. So here are time and space complexity, that is big O B raised to C by E. C is the cost of optimal solution and E is the cost of each action. So now let's consider here a graph. Here S is the start node and G is the goal node. So this algorithm works by maintaining two lists, closed and open. So let's start. First of all, S. So cost of source will always be zero. So just copy it here in closed list, nothing else. Now it begins. Now from S we can move either to A or C, which cost 5 and 6 respectively. So cost of moving to A is 5, that is 5, and to C is 6. Done. Now we have to select here the minimum value, and we have to move it to closed list. So here it's A with minimum 5, and here I'm moving it to closed list. So once we are moving any node to closed list, then we have to expand that node and all others will be as it is. C6 as it is, thereafter expanding A. So from A we can go to either B or D. So if we go to B, then it would be 5 and 1, 6. And if we go to D, then it would be 7. So B6 and D7. Now here both the nodes C and B contain same cost, 6 and 6. So for simplicity, I am considering the first one, C6. These both are as it is and we have to expand C. So from C here we can go to D, G or H. Now the cost of moving to D is 11, but here the cost of D is already 7. 11 is greater than 7, so ignore the value of D. And we have to write all other values of G and H. So G would be 11 and H would be 7. Now from here minimum is 6, so move it to here. This all will be as it is. Now there is only one option from B, that is to E. So it will be E and total cost will be 9. So here both values are equal, D and H 7, so we can consider any one of them. Here I am considering D. So move it to here. Now we have to expand D. So here it can go to either E or G. But if it will go to E, then what will be its cost? 7 plus 4, 11. But here the cost of E is 9. So ignore this value. It will be 9 only. And cost to G will be? Now the cost of G will be 10. Here it's 11. So just cut it and replace it with 10, lower value. Now from here minimum is 7, so move it to here. So here we have to expand H. So there is only one option of H to I. So it will be I8. Now from here minimum is I8. So again move it to here. Sorry, G11 is already replaced by G10. So it would be G10, E9. And we have to expand this I. So now I can go to either G or J, but the cost of going to G will be always will obviously be greater than 10. So just ignore this value, and to J it will be 9. Now again same values, and I am moving this E. Now from J, it can go to G and cost will be 10. Here it is 10 only. So, okay. Now finally, E is already present. So here the cost of moving from I to G is also 10, and here it is also present 10, so it's okay, equal value, we can consider them. Now from here minimum is E9, so again I am moving it here. So from here, from E, we can move to either G or F. But here, moving from E to G cost 7, which will be obviously greater than 10. So simply ignore this value. Now, moving to F will be 10. Moving to F will be also 10. Now, I am moving this goal state to closed list. Now, once goal state is moved to closed list, then it is termination point. That means algorithm is over. Now, consider a special case and assume if there is a path from this D to S and assume that its cost is 1, then what will happen? S will go to A, A will find D, and D will again find S with minimum value. So these steps are repeated for infinite times, and thus it will get stuck in a infinite loop and it can never come back. So this is the main disadvantage of this method. Now, depth limited search. So here depth limit is given equals to 2. That means it will explore up to level 2. It won't go to level 3. So in simple terms, we can say that it will find all the nodes at level 2, but it will not expand all those. So exploring sequence will be A, B, then D, then E. Then after this E, it will move directly to C, then F, and then G. So here are given time and space complexities. Time complexity will be B raised to L, where B are the actual levels and L is given limit, and space complexity will be B into L. Now last approach, iterative deepening DFS. So this is a combination of BFS plus DFS. So it will search level wise. First of all, consider up to level 1. Then it searching sequence will be like A, B, and then C. Then consider up to 2. Then from A it will go to B, then D, then E. After this E, it will move to C. Thereafter F, and thereafter G. Now consider one more level. So in this level, it will go to A, then B, then D, then H, then I. After this, it will again move to E, J, K. After K, it will directly move to C, thereafter F, thereafter L, thereafter M, then G, N, and O. Finally, O is our goal node. So it will stop here and it will not explore more levels. So once this goal node is found, it will not go to more levels. It will stop here. Thank you.